In this video, you'll see how to integrate New Relic with AWS Control Tower. With this solution, you can simplify New Relic deployment at scale, automate observability across multiple accounts, and centrally manage deployed resources. For the purposes of our example, we have already deployed some prerequisites. This is our existing AWS Control Tower environment. Let's take a quick look at our New Relic account. If you don't have a New Relic account, you can sign up for a free trial at New Relic or use the AWS Marketplace to subscribe to New Relic. Let's return to AWS Control Tower to take a look at our AWS accounts. We'll be adding the two accounts in the Custom Organization Unit, or OU, as part of our New Relic deployment. Let's view Vending Account 1. We'll copy down the account ID, which we'll need for the deployment. Let's do the same for Vending Account 2. Next, we'll need to retrieve our New Relic account ID. We can find the account ID in our subscription management settings. We'll also need a user API key in order to use the New Relic Nerd Graph and REST APIs. Let's create the key. Let's copy the key we just created. Next, we'll navigate to AWS CloudFormation to configure the template for our integration. Let's create the stack. For the template source, we'll paste in the Amazon S3 URL from the AWS Quick Start titled New Relic AWS Control Tower Integration on the AWS Cloud. You can find this Quick Start in the description and links for this video. We'll name the stack and provide values for a few parameters that require input. Here we'll paste in the New Relic account ID we copied earlier. Next, we'll paste in the Nerd Graph user key. We can also specify a Nerd Graph API endpoint. For our purposes, let's keep the default setting. Next, we'll paste in the AWS account IDs we copied down earlier. This step can be skipped if you don't have accounts already managed by Control Tower that you want to include. We'll retain the default settings for the rest of the options. Let's review the settings and create the stack. Now that the template has been deployed, let's validate the deployment by finding the infrastructure in the New Relic account. Here we can see the two AWS account IDs we added, each followed by a list of the AWS entities in the account. To further validate the integration, let's try creating a new account in the AWS Control Tower Account Factory. We'll provision a new account and enroll it in the custom OU. It'll take about 45 minutes to enroll the new account. Let's skip ahead to the end of that process. As you can see, the account has been successfully provisioned. Let's note the account ID and then look for this account in New Relic. Here's the account we just provisioned. As you can see, it was automatically registered in New Relic. From here, we can access the account's status dashboard to see a high-level overview of its activities. We can also investigate the entities in the Explorer view. The New Relic Explorer provides access and gives context to performance data from all your monitored AWS entities. You've just seen how to integrate New Relic with AWS Control Tower. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.